Welcome back. Now, instead of picking up the morning paper, reading it over a cup of coffee, many people today get their news on their tablets instead. And that means they get stories from multiple sources at the same time. A number of news aggregation apps help people to do just that. One popular option is Pulse. It is a free app for Android, iOS, and Windows 8. And Pulse has about 20 million users. Here is what it looks like. You choose the sources that you want to follow, and then it brings you new headlines and top stories. Another option is Zeit, which I should mention was acquired by CNN in 2011. It also is free. It runs on Android, iOS, and Windows Phone. Zeit says it tailors story selection for you. It learns what you like to read and personalize feature picks. And last but not least, Flipboard. It is a free app for Android and iOS. It recently announced it has more than 50 million users, and it is unveiling a new version with a new curation feature that allows anyone to run their own magazine inside the app. Now, it's a development that's prompted some to call it a major threat to established media brands online. In fact, one commentator called Flipboard, quote, a giant iceberg lurking in the path of the media. Wow. CEO and co-founder of Flipboard, Mike McCue, joins us now live from New York. Mike, good to see you. Congratulations with the launch of Flipboard 2.0. And using it, I've noticed that the biggest change is curation. Users now, they can become the creators of online magazines. They can become publishers themselves. It's pretty cool, but why would an average person want to do that?
Well, you know, if you really are interested in places that you might want to visit someday, or perhaps you're going to be remodeling your house and you want to sort of save and collect great ideas for remodeling, or if you're really into a hobby, like you're into sailing or horseback riding, you can build your own personal magazine now on Flipboard 2.0 out of all the things that you love and think are important about that particular topic. And then you can share that magazine with the world, with your friends, or you can just keep it private and use it as your own personal collection. Hmm. So it's a really cool new feature that people are loving in this new release.
So you can create your own magazine. It could be a scrapbook, it could be a brag book, whatever it is. But is there an appetite out there for people to subscribe to those curated magazines?
Absolutely. There have been hundreds of thousands of magazines already created so far by our readers around the world. And we're seeing magazines for all sorts of different things. Magazines that are for example, professional equestrian, riders. It could be for travel guides around, for cities around the world, like Barcelona and London. We've seen magazines get created by teachers who are, organizing content for their students. Magazines by cancer researchers who are pulling together great content around the latest in cancer genetics. So, there's I think what we're finding is that a lot of people have a lot to say. They have a lot of desire to curate and organize content. They don't necessarily want to create a blog. That's a little too technical for them. This gives them a very easy way to do that.
So, and can there be big money to be created here through curation? Can those who decide to create their own magazines inside Flipboard be making money, revenue with you?
Well, yes. We focus by our fundamental principle and big reason why we started the company is that we believe that it's extremely important for high quality journalism and great content to thrive online. And I think that the future has never been brighter for publishers. And we work very, very closely with the publishing world. We have over 1,000 different publishers that we partner with around the world to help them get their content out to a new generation of readers who are discovering their content on these mobile devices, on these social networks, and make that content look great, monetize it with beautiful full-page ads, and really take their media operations into a new realm.
Now, you didn't quite answer my question there about revenue plans for curation. Do you have anything in the works?
Well, we are thinking a lot about how we could allow people, individuals who are curating magazines to be able to generate revenue. But our first priority is enabling the publishers whose content can get curated within these magazines to generate revenue. That's priority one. And then, you know, we'll take a look at ways that we can enable, you know, individual readers to ultimately participate in that economic scenario in the future.
Okay, and even though that, you know, this new curation function has been called the great iceberg in the face of media, you've made it quite clear, you know, it is about the content after all. You're working with mainstream media as well as encouraging your users, average users, to become their own publishers in their own right. So is your competition then other news aggregators like Pulse, Insight, and even, this is more interesting, I think, other curation sites, social network sites like Pinterest and Tumblr? Are you really going after them?
We're not really trying to go after anybody. You know, we really believe in the concept of a magazine. You know, if you go to any newsstand, you know, today, you'll see magazines for practically anything you can imagine. But that world of those print magazines is declining. And what's happening is that people are getting their content from these mobile devices and social networks. And what we want to do is give publishers a way to have that content be just as great as what you see in those great magazines on the newsstand, but have it work across this new world of mobile and social. So that's really been our primary focus. And when we think about it for our readers, it's about collecting all the things that they love, pictures of their friends and their kids, great articles about an industry that they're into, you know, great movies and podcasts and music for a hobby that they have, you know, and pulling all that together in one single place. So there's really nothing else like it. It's a new way of thinking about a magazine.